Oh geez, sorry guys. Hello, we're back. It's Tuesday's tip of the week. If you guys are new to my YouTube channel, I specialize in hair extensions and I actually created a method called Natural Beaded Row hair extensions. So if you want more information on that, click on the link directly below this video. But we're gonna talk about beach wavy hair and I'm gonna show you how I use this product that I just sprayed in all of your guys' faces. And I'm also gonna tell you what is like my favorite curling iron. I have tons and tons and tons of curling videos, but I'm constantly trying different irons, different sizes, different ways of curling it. So I wanted to share with you guys today an updated curling video of how I'm currently doing my hair if you are loving it. And also, if you are a Natural Beaded Rows fan, I am wearing 3 rows of hair extensions. So anyways, that always helps hold the curl and makes it extra beachy. But we're gonna go ahead and get started. I do have it curled, so this is just gonna be like a short video to kind of, so you can kind of get the idea of how I did it. And you can still use all the same products if you don't wear hair extensions. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. What you'll need is just one of these fun little clips. And I honestly curl my hair in like 5 minutes. I know some girls when they're doing hair curling videos, they section each thing out and like, I often wonder if they really do that at home or if they just do that for a video. So I'm gonna show you guys how I would do it when I'm at home. I'm not gonna section like 17 different sections. We're just gonna get started. Okay, so say my hair was completely straight. The only part that I would clip up is I always take my real hair layers and I clip those little guys up. I don't usually put any product in my hair before I start curling it. If I do, sometimes, let me grab, if I do add any oil to my hair or any product to my hair, sometimes before curling it, I'll just add like a dime size of this Unite oil. It's amazing. If you guys wear hair extensions and your extensions start to feel kind of dry, this will save your life. Dab a little bit of this and some heat on it, not too much. You don't want to fry your hair or your hair extensions. It kind of smooths everything and makes it feel a lot softer. So I just would put a little bit of that in before curling. Now, yes, my hair is already curled. I'm just kind of showing you guys a short demo of how I achieve this cute, messy, beachy wave look. And then see how it's kind of separated like this? That's because of the product I use. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so I'm like always trying different curling irons and I love this size. I think this is the 1 inch. I normally would use the 1¼ inch, but lately I have been using a little bit smaller one and I feel like it's creating more of that S pattern that I'm looking for to get a really beachy, beachy look. And what you're gonna do is I normally start, you know, around or like right by my face and I wrap everything back. And when I get halfway through, when I get halfway back, I switch and go to the other side and I wrap everything back and around. So we're gonna kind of go ahead and get started. I am naughty and I have my curling iron turned up all the way. I know that's kind of a no-no, but here's the thing, a little heat tip I'm gonna share with you guys. If you're not a stylist and you don't know how to manage the tension in the iron, I would suggest actually turning your heat down to, this one has a 50 for a max. If you're not good with tension in your iron and maybe you don't do hair, turn it to 35. I know that's so tiny and you guys can't see. Us hairstylists, we know, when I say tension, this is the tension in your iron. So we kind of know how to use it so it's less tension, therefore applying less heat on our hair. So again, if you're that girl that's over curling or heating your hair and you have fine hair, just back the heat off a little bit just to be safe. So I'm gonna kind of go ahead and get started. My heat is up a little bit and I'm just gonna kind of show you how you do it. So you're gonna grab, you know, you're gonna start right around your face, you know guys, and I run it through just a little bit, but do you notice I'm not clamping all the way down? Do you guys see how I'm doing that? I think I forget to share that in all my other videos, but I'm letting the heat slide through the hair, but I'm not releasing my tension completely. What this does is it's kind of smoothing it a little bit, but not frying the hair completely. So that's kind of, that's a pretty important step. So I do a couple passes, and then what I do is I start the curl, and again, I'm kind of constantly moving that iron so that that heat's not on there. Now let your curl sit. I know it's like, it looks like a ringlet and you, it might be driving you crazy and you automatically wanna pull the curl out. Don't. Let the curl sit and cool and then break it apart at the end. Okay, so let's go ahead and move on to the next piece. Again, I'm gonna grab, I would say that's about an inch section and I'm gonna run it through a couple times. Again, you don't have to run it through. I do because I feel like it helps smooth. And if you wear hair extensions and you find your extensions are getting a little bit tangly, I can promise you just smoothing over it a little bit will help smooth the hair extension hair. So again, running that over a little bit, then I start the bend right here at the top. You can see rolling that away from my face, not letting that heat sit on too long. and I leave my ends out and then just direct it. I'm kind of directing my wrist and rolling and pulling that down. Now, I feel like I'm giving you guys so much information just by simply curling your hair, but you would be surprised, people that sit in my chair at my salon say, Danielle, what are you doing? I can't do my curls like you. And so I thought, oh my God, I gotta do another video, and maybe it's just the tension and the way that I'm kind of rolling my wrist. So I wanted to share that with you guys. Okay, let's keep going. Again, you can see these are very kind of a ringlet shape, but I'm gonna pull it apart. So again, sliding my curling iron over there, a couple passes, and oh man, that beeping is like driving me nuts. And then I just kind of slowly bring it down. Okay, and again, letting it cool. When it kind of sets there for a minute, you can then slowly kind of break that up, and you can see how that definitely creates more of a beach look when you break all those curls up. And then to get back here, this like little secret window here, I always pull this forward, again, running my curling iron over a few times. And again, I don't section my hair in like 17 different sections. I just kind of grab sections underneath and curl where I need to curl pretty much. Okay, so after I get that whole side done, I typically will let this, and like, obviously this is a short version, and then I will come over here, do the same thing to this side, and start curling away from the face. Then when I get to the top, I don't put as much curl in my real hair, so I might grab a section of my real hair with the extensions and just barely bend it in there. That's all I'm gonna do, even less heat on my real hair, my baby fine hair. Again, I can't tell you how many clients come in and they're like, I don't know what's going on with my hair, and I know right away it's because they're the girl curling her flat iron every day with too much tension on their irons or too much heat. So be very aware of that when you're curling your hair. Okay, so then I'm gonna just keep grabbing sections of both my real hair and the hair extensions and just rolling it right in there and kind of creating that look. Now, people always ask me how I get this wave in my bang. Like, I can't figure it out. So I'll show you guys how I do my bangs. I grab this section, my bangs are so fragile, I'm gonna like turn my heat completely off just to show you. And I usually curl this just barely and direct it all the way forward in front of my face. And then I kind of give it a little tug because I don't want my bangs to have a lot of curl in them. And it just kind of creates just a teeny bit of a wave. So you can see now that I've kind of gotten those curls through the top, I'm gonna go through and I just break everything up like so. And I don't know why, but when with extensions, when they stick together, I take my hands and I kind of just fan everything out a little bit. And then what I'll do to finish off is I'm kind of obsessed with this product line. I carry it at my salon. A, because I love the packaging, and B, because I really love the product. But this is by Unite, and it's their dry finishing spray. It's what I sprayed on you guys at the beginning of this video. But what I'll do is I'll just give it a little spray, especially on the ends. Like if you wanna maybe give your ends a little bit of texture, you know, make them extra beachy, I'll spray that in and see what I'm doing with my hands. I'm kind of really separating that hair. And then you can actually, I love this spray because it has a little bit of hold. So you can kind of mist it over the top and it will give it a little bit of hold. And the other thing I'll do is on day one, say you just washed your hair, I even will spray it right in at the roots and kind of work it in there. And that's pretty much it. So that's kind of my cute little messy beach wave. One last tip, I feel like I'm just ranting on this video, but flyaways are cool this year, guys. So sometimes at my salon, we have some other videos where we were actually like putting a baby balloon on the hair to give it flyaways. But I often will just like mess it up. And I don't, that's kind of the thing this year, is like really fuzzy hair up here. And then after I kind of give it a little bit of body, I'll even spray it just like a hairspray, a little bit on the top, and it doesn't weigh it down. Just a little bit goes a long way. So anyways, I just wanted to share an updated video on how I'm doing my beach wave. Again, I used the Babliss iron, this is their 1-inch. And these are hot irons. So again, just be very careful with the tension and both the heat on this iron, so. All right, you guys, thanks for joining me again here on today's Tuesday tip on how to create these beachy, messy waves. So we'll see you guys every Tuesday for Tuesday tip of the week. This is Chloe, say hi, Chloe. All right, you guys, don't forget to subscribe and I'll see you next Tuesday.